In this video I'm going to show you how to use the pure Photoshop action. Okay, so what I'm actually going to do is I'm going to use this photo here as an example for a demonstration. Okay, so I'm going to create from this photo this effect using this action. So as you can see, what the action does, it creates this soft and pure look of your photos. Okay, and the action also desaturates your photo, but you'll be asked during the action to brush the areas that you wish to colorize, and also the action will one stop to ask you which areas you wish to sharpen. Okay, so let me just show you a few examples that I have made using this action. So for this photo I created this. Okay, let's get back to our photo. So I'm just gonna close this window. So when you open up your photo, before you use the action, there are a few things that you should check to make sure the action will run without any errors. Okay, so the first thing that you should check is that your photo is a background layer. Okay, so it should be called a background and have this lock icon. So if it's something like this or anything else, just go to layer, new, and choose a background from layer. Okay, and also click on this little arrow here and just go to the panel options and make sure you got this option checked, add copy to copied layers and groups. Okay, and go to image mode and make sure your photo is in RGB color mode 8-bit kernel. Also check the image size here, and your photo should be at least 1400 pixels wide or high. Okay, so this 14 to 1500 pixels, so this photo is okay size, and resolution should be between 72 and 300 pixels. Okay, so just gonna click okay. To load the action, just go to window, actions, click on this little arrow here and load actions, and just choose the action that came in download. Okay, it will appear now in your actions panel. And to load the brushes, you can just pick a brush tool, click somewhere on your canvas, and just click on the little gear or here. You can just go to load brushes and just choose the brushes that can be downloaded. Okay, so the brush will appear here. And now what you have to do is to create a new layer. So you can just go to layer, new, choose new layer, and just name it brush. And it's important that all letters are lowercase. Okay, otherwise the action won't work. Just click OK. And all you have to do is to pick a brush tool, which picks a soft brush, and color does not matter, just pick some colors so you can clearly see what you have brushed. And all you have to do is to just brush over your subject, just like this, okay? And I have already done this before, so I just gonna open my PSD, okay? So I have, when you finish with brushing, all you have to do is to play the action. And the action will stop for 2 times with the messages, so I'm going to fasten the video here and get back to when the first message shows, okay? So just click on the play button. Okay, so the first message just pop up. So it says, now brush over the areas that you want to colorize. Click stop to proceed. Okay, so the proper brush will be already selected. All you have to do is to just brush over the areas that you wish to colorize, as in the message says. So just like this. Okay, and just brush like this. You can adjust the brush size, and also if you wish to colorize some areas but only a little bit, you can just lower the opacity here of the brush. Okay, so it will just add a little bit of colors. Okay, so I'm just gonna brush like this here. And I'm gonna brush over here as well. And you can just hold the Alt button, or for PC or for Mac, and just click on the layer mask to see if you have made, if you missed some parts of the areas that you want to brush, just like this. Okay. And I'm going to lower the opacity, something like this. And just going to brush a little bit over here. So you can see the difference when you use the lower opacity brush. It will just bring a little bit colors, okay? Just like that. You can also, if you brush some areas, but you change your mind and you don't want to colorize the areas, you can just switch the colors here, so, and the brush with the white color. I can just, for example, lower the opacity like this, and just saturate a little bit these areas that I have brushed, okay, just like this. Okay. So after finishing brushing, all you have to do is to just click play again, and the action will stop once more. Okay, so I'm again going to fasten the video and get back when the next message pops up. Okay. Okay, so here is the second message, and it says, now brush over the areas that you would like to sharpen. Choose stop to proceed. So again, the proper brush will be selected, so just gonna increase the opacity to, let's say, 90, like this. And just gonna lower the size of the brush a little bit, and I'm just gonna brush like this. Okay. Just like that. And again, you can just hold Alt or Option and click this layer mask to see which edge you have brushed. Just like this. Okay. And also, if you've brushed over the some areas that you in general you might not want to sharpen them, just change this to white. And when you start brushing, you'll remove the sharpen. Okay. Okay, just gonna change color back to black. Just gonna use a 100 opacity. Just gonna brush like this. Okay, and this was the last message. So there are no any more messages. Windows that will pop up any messages more. Okay, so I'm going to just click play again and fasten the video here again and get back when the action is finished. And then I'm going to show you how to customize the result that you got. Okay. Okay, so the action here just finished. So I just close the actions panel and. Let's see what we got here. Okay, so just open the folder. So here let's start from the adjustments. So just scale this. Like, okay. So here we got the fine sharpening layer. So what this layer does, this layer creates a fine sharpening. So it actually sharpen the small details on your photo. Okay, and to change the amount of sharpen, you just have to change its opacity. So you can just click on this word opacity, drag it aside like this. Okay, so you can see the difference. So just make some value that you like. And this is the hard sharpening. And what it does actually is it actually brings a sharpening and a little bit of contrast. Okay, and also just click on the word opacity, just drag it aside. Okay, you can see the difference. So let's set it like this. This is the overall brightness, so when you double click over here, you can change the brightness by moving these three indicators here, okay, these three pointers, and this is the overall contrast, okay, so this is just giving some nice contrast to your photo, and you just click on the vertical opacity, drag it aside. This is very sensitive here, okay, as you can see. Okay, this is the overall vibrance. So when double click here, you can add a vibrance to your photo and also the saturation. Okay, or you can saturate the photo. Okay, it depends what kind of effect you wish to achieve. So I'm just gonna add a little bit of saturation and the vibrance like this. And this is the background blur here. And what this layer does, it creates the blur around your subject. So I got a white background here, so it's actually not visible, but You can also change the amount of blur by changing its opacity. Okay, you will see it will blur a little bit the edges here when you change to 100. And you get the layer mask here. So if you just hold the shift button click here, you'll see I remove the layer mask. So you can just click on this layer mask here, pick a brush, pick some soft brush, and set foreground color white. And you can just brush like this to the areas that you wish to blur. Okay, so you can just add some nice blur like this here. Okay, and as you're controlling the amount of blur here, okay, I'm just gonna lower it like this. Okay, and this is the main effect. Okay, so you can also change the opacity here. Okay, I'm just gonna leave it to 100. And what you can do after you finish with customizing, you can just make a new layer, go to image, apply image, and you can play with it a little bit with the dodge and burn tools. Okay, the dodge tool will increase the will lighten up the areas that you have brushed with it. Okay, so you can here you can choose which areas you wish that it affects. Okay, if you choose the shadows, it will then lighten up the shadows. You see, if you choose the highlights, it will just increase the highlights even more. Okay, you can choose the exposure here. So if you set something like this, it will just highlight a little bit. If you set to 100, it will highlight much more. Okay, so you can just increase the highlights on some areas. Just lower it like this, for example. Set the midtones and just do it like this. Okay. And or using a burn tool, it's just the opposite tool of the dodge tool. It will just darken the edges of your brush. It's also you're choosing the which areas which the effect and the exposure. Okay, so for example, choose the highlights. If you lower the exposure like this, it will darken up the highlights. Okay. And I'm just gonna save this photo, and I'm just gonna open it in my other Photoshop here that I got here, CC version. Okay. Because just find the photo. Okay, so again, just make a new layer, go to image and apply image. And this Photoshop version got this camera raw filter. Okay, so just gonna use it to add some final touch to the photo. Okay, let's just zoom it like this. So what you get here is the temperature of your photo. So just gonna lower it like this. You got a tint here. Okay, just gonna add it a little bit like this. This is the exposure. Okay. So just gonna make set this here. Increase the clarity a little bit, vibrant saturation, and maybe add a little bit more sharpening here, just like this, because I already got the sharpening using the adjustment layer we got there. Okay, so that's it. Let's just quickly check the before and after. So from this photo, created this effect. Okay, so I'm pretty much happy with this result. And if you still need any help or you got any questions, feel free to contact me anytime via my Elvato profile page. And thanks for watching.